Welcome, dear children. I welcome you all to the English corner. Today, what we are going to do? Yes, we are going to learn a new topic, fourth chapter, right? The name of the lesson? Come on. We'll see later. Before you go into the lesson, we will have a small clue, okay? Before you read. In 1997, an Indian-American, Kalpana Chawla, was part of the international crew aboard the US Space Shuttle Columbia, becoming the first woman in India to go into space. Sadly, the second mission in Columbia ended in tragedy. This is what is the clue given. And I want to ask you a small question. Okay? What is it? What is a space? Come on, children. I am waiting for your response.
Hello, ma'am. I am K. Bridget from 60A. The difference between spaceship and aeroplane. Now, I am going to tell ma'am. A spaceship will fly in the above the atmosphere. But the aeroplane will fly in lower of the atmosphere.
Super Prajit, fantastic answer.
Very good, Prajit. Now we will see another one. Right? Same, Prajit.
Space is where the stars and planets exist. And spaceship is an electrical vehicle which flies in space. Thank you.
Very good. So now, good answer by Prajit. We will see how Srinithi answers.
Good evening, ma'am. I am Srinithi. Space is a place, ma'am. But spaceship is a vehicle that flies through space.
Fantastic answer, dear. So, I'm moving into the lesson. An Indian-American woman in space, Kalpana Chawla. We are going to learn about Kalpana Chawla. So now you got an idea of what a space is and what a spaceship is. That is what we are going to learn more in detail. Okay. A space shuttle is a spacecraft that is made for repeated space travel. Like for example, between Earth and a space station. Can you see so many stations are here, right? So now this is what is a space shuttle. Is it clear? Now use your dictionary. Always in English class, you should have a dictionary with you, dear, right? Have your dictionary and find out the meanings, right? Shall we start? First question is, naturalized US citizen. What is the answer? Naturalization. See, for example, if a person belongs to India, going to America, right? Do you think he is a citizen of India or a citizen of America? What do you think? He is a citizen of India only, right? But what happens? He is living there for so many years, so many generations. And newborn baby was there. Maybe his or her daughter, son, anybody. What do you think that daughter or son, that small baby belongs to India or he or she belongs to America? Otherwise, he is an Indian citizen or an American citizen. You tell me the answer, dear. I am waiting for your answer in the next meeting. Right. So, there are some legal act or process by which a non-citizen in a country may acquire citizenship or nationality of that country. It may be done automatically by a statute, that is without any effort on the part of the individual, or it may involve an application or a motion and approval by legal authorities. So you have to follow certain rules and regulations, and they will have some laws how they have to give citizenship, right? So next is about space. What is a space? That is what we discussed. A space is a continuous area or expanse which is free, available, or unoccupied. That is what is a space. Then what is the meaning of frontier? The limit of knowledge or the most advanced achievement in a particular field is frontier, right? Again, a frontier, the limit of knowledge or the most advanced achievement in a particular field, right? If you are very good in mathematics, then you are the frontier. Okay, next is about. About is a preposition, right? On or into. For example, a ship, aircraft, train, whatever vehicles you can take. I climbed aboard the yacht. Yacht spelling is wrong here. Y-A-T-C-H. Okay. So now you can assume that you are going to climb into the yacht. Right? Climb on the yacht. Whatever it is. On is on the top and into is inside the yacht. Right? So two persons are sitting here. Where are they sitting? They are sitting in the yes port, inside the aircraft, maybe inside the aircraft. So they are sitting aboard the aircraft, right? So aboard is on or into. Next, what is lift off? What is lift off? And what is the difference between liftoff and takeoff? Liftoff of an aircraft or spacecraft or a rocket, right? So it is used to fly out vertically. That is what is liftoff. You can see the figure. One aeroplane is there and one spacecraft is moving. How the aeroplane is moving? Little bit slanting, isn't it? But how a spacecraft is moving? Exactly straight, vertical. So now this is the difference. Takeoff and liftoff. Liftoff and takeoff both have the same meaning, but slightly differs in taking off. If it is vertical, then it is called liftoff. If it is slanting in other position, it is called takeoff, right? So, shall we move to the next meaning? Crew. Crew, it's a noun. It's a group of people who work on and operate a ship, an aircraft, etc. So, here I gave the picture of Kalpana Chawla along with their teammates, along with their crew. So, crew is a group of people who work on and operate a ship, aircraft, etc. Right? Next, see here, notice the spelling of the words airplane program. What is the spelling of airplane given here is A-I-R-P-L-A-N-E. But actually, what we are learning is aeroplane, A-E-R-O-P-L-A-N-E. What is the difference? So, airplane is the spelling that is used in American English and aeroplane is in British English. So, children, there are some differences in British English and American English. What we are following is basically British English. So, the spelling may differ. Note it down and underline the words and find out the equivalent spelling of British English. Program, P-R-O-G-R-A-M is given there. But actually, the spelling of program is PROGRAMME, program, where the word program refers in software programming. In a computer science, you could have written so many programs, JavaScript and other programs you will write. There you will use the word program, PROGRAMME. But here, program, PROGRAM refers to the program, PROGRAMME. So there will be a confusion in British English and American English in the spelling. Just check it out and underline what are the American words used in this lesson. Right? Shall we move to the next slide here? A news report. Right? A tragedy in space. US space shuttle Columbia breaks into flames. So really, it is a tragedy. We lost our Indo-American scientist. So many scientists we lost. Really, breathtaking news. In an unprecedented space tragedy, US space shuttle Columbia carrying India-born American astronaut Kalpana Chawla and six others broke apart in flames as it streaked over Texas towards its landing strip on Saturday, 1st February 2003. So when this happened is 1st February 2003. Killing all seven on board. All seven members were died. The shuttle lost contact with NASA at about 9 a.m. 1930 hours IST as it came for landing. It was flying at an altitude of over 2 lakh feet and traveling at over 20,000 km per hour. When ground control lost contact with the shuttle, Columbia had lifted off on January 16, 2003 from the Kennedy Space Center, Florida. It stayed in orbit for 16 days. How many days? 16 days. And seven member crew conducted 80 experiments. See, fantastic. Such a good team, such a good crew that is. So before it began a downward journey, which ended in tragedy. This was Columbia's 28th space flight and the shuttle was said to be good for 100 flights. So children, this is the news report, right? So now only we are entering into the chapter. Kalpana Chawla said that she never dreamed as a child in Kurnool that she would cross the frontiers of space. So where she was born in Kurnool. She would never dream that she will cross the frontiers of space. She will never dream about the space. It was enough that her parents allowed her to attend engineering college after she graduated from Tagore School. Where she studied? She studied in Tagore School. Right? After a Bachelor of Science degree in Aeronautical Engineering. Now, she completed her engineering, Aeronautical Engineering. Against great opposition from her father, she went a master's degree to United States. So, her father didn't allow her to study in US. He opposed her. He opposed her, but she didn't listen. After a great opposition from her father, she went and studied master's degree in United States. Can you able to see her father? B.L. Chawla. So, this is Kalpana Chawla's father. Right, children? Kalpana Chawla's father. So, she went to complete her degree, master's degree in USA. She later earned her PhD also in aerospace engineering. Both are related. Right, children, time is up. We will meet in the next session in the same slide.